Hey guys, Manel just finished validating the base of the golden prototype, and now I'm going to find him to ask for some updates.
In the validating of the base of the race keyboard, we are testing a lot of different things. The resistance of the base material, the fitting with the aluminum case, the mylar sticker, dimensions and fitting, also the rubber legs, the friction with the table, is good, is not good. A lot of different things, but the most important thing is the light underglow. Let me show you. There are three main light sources in the keyboard. The first one is the Huble light. The next one is the backlight of the keycaps, and the last one is the underglow of the base. This is the base golden prototype. The base has a light pipe that is a transparent piece of polycarbonate. The main function of this part is to distribute the light from the PCB to the edges, to the perimeter. So we have like an even light in the underglow. The other main part of the base is the diffuser. The diffuser is like a plastic piece in the edge, and the main task of this piece is to diffuse the light. So you don't see like the light spots of the LEDs. You see like an even surface around the keyboard. So these two pieces are the main pieces of the base, and we made a golden prototype gluing both with optical glue. During the design process of this piece, we hired a consultant expert in lighting and light distribution, and we did like a 3D model of the base and a simulation of the light. So we are sure that we have the same level of light in any point of the perimeter. There are mainly two things we wanted to validate with the base about the light. It was the evenness of the light and also the intensity of the light. Both are very important. We want an even light and also a very intense light. If the user chooses to have intense light, you can also control that. All the simulations are related with the evenness, and all the electronics and the choice of the LEDs and the LED driver and all the design of the PCB is related with the intensity of this light. To increase the light intensity inside the keyboard, what we did is create a white box. So the mylar of the base, the mylar sticker, we did it with white color in the top and aluminum color in the bottom. We also did the PCBs in white color, so we have like two white surfaces around the lights. And there are like bounces and reflections inside the keyboard. So it's like a good solution to increase the intensity. In general, we can say we are happy and we can go ahead with the molding with this piece because we have checked or validated that the light is moving properly around the perimeters. We still have to design a lot of different light effects, color and stuff. But the most important thing is we have intense light and even light.
If you're interested to learn more about the race keyboard, you can click the subscribe button. Or if you're interested to purchase one of these beauties, you can head over to our website at dygma.com.